1993 Entertainer of the Year, Shayla Simpson.
Here, I haven't had a damn drink all night. That's why I can't talk. got lipstick on my eye teeth, can't see what the fuck I'm saying. Also, I want to thank Bobby and Rick. Thank you so much. I was sitting up here, I saw the cigarettes, and I went, oh, and I got bitching before I even looked. They left me a sweet little note. It says, Hurricane, Bobby and Rick, sorry they didn't have your brand in the concession stand. We love you. I got to give it up for somebody buying me a cigarette, somebody helping me to die. I don't care, girl. No, bitch, you know, and I do not mind. Have you ever seen, you ever watch Bruce, you ever watch Willard Scott in the morning? Ladies and gentlemen, this is Ethel May. Ethel May's 102 today, and she's over in the corner going, ripe young old age, I'm going to be on stage one day and go, fall over dead. Ladies and gentlemen, let's do a shot. Cheer everybody up. Here's... Yeah. Georgie Porgy Pudding Pie shot a wad in his lover's eye. When that eye did crust a chut, he went on and fucked that one-eyed slut. Cheers. Smooth. Keep it coming, you little bastards. They get better as you go down. Ladies and gentlemen, right now, please give it up. Welcome to the stage. In Evening Vare Competition. Creative Evening Vare Competition. I'm waiting on some music. That's your cue to start the music, because find out the name of the music, don't start bitch standing there, it should be bitter. Ladies and gentlemen, representing Bluegrass Regional EOY, give it up for contestant number 18, Ashley Cripple.
Okay, she does now.
You don't know, okay. Never mind, you don't want to know. What's good to see you? You are?
My name is Shantae.
Shantae, I'm sure it is. Honey, last year was her very first drag pageant. Her name was Mary Ann. She came back this year, new hairstyle, big titties, and her name is Shantae. You figure it out. Alright, good to see you, baby. She's one of the Bud Light people. She'll be walking around the club tonight handing out some stuff. Bud Light's giving out gift certificates and all that stuff. So, kids, don't kill yourself. Order yourself a goddamn Bud Light. Shut the hell up. I'm sorry, I love the stuff. But in drag, you have to pee, so I don't drink a lot of it. Lady? First beer of the night. Ladies and gentlemen, if you will, representing Georgia EOI. That was good. We're getting the swing of this. Please give it up for contestant number 20, Mary Edith Pitts.
Ladies and gentlemen, if you will, good, yeah?
if you will, ladies and gentlemen. In group five, this is contestant number 21. Ladies and gentlemen, she is representing Mid Tri-State's EOY. Give it up for Aman Valentino.
Lopos.
Hey.
I got one of them Barbie cakes for my birthday last year. All right, honey, you know when that bitch comes into a room. Couches falling over, chairs, not lamps. But she look good. Sean, here. Here's to the men that are 3'2". If there wasn't a circus, there'd be no work for you. But being that short isn't a total bummer. You never have to dirty your knees to please your lovers. Cheers. You know what? I'm drinking. I don't care if you clap or not. Fuck it. Ladies and gentlemen, if you will, representing Miss Dream Girl. E-O-Y. Give it up for contestant number 23, Versace.
Give it up for contestant number 24, Nicole Love Dupree!
them a big round of applause. That is the promoters for EOY, who are the ones who get these bitches up here and get the contest going. And see, they're the only reason we're here. Give it up for them. I'll tell you why. Because Nicole's fucking outfit made me think of that, bitch, because you know there's some fag back there going, she's missing a stone. Somebody glue that back on there. And those are the people who make it important, girl, because you know there's some fag back there with a hot glue gun going. Got some little fag gnome. Got some little fag gnome in the basement going, I hope Nicole likes this dress. I can go back and stand in the yard. I'll be fine. Is that, ladies and gentlemen, I want you to give a big round of applause to the general manager here. I believe that's him up in the booth. Is that Tom up there? See? Give it up for Tom Remix up there in the booth. It's probably not the time or the place, but Tom, you told me to tell you this last night. I'd like to be paid tonight. Thank you. Yeah. Ladies and gentlemen. She went to me, I said, Tom? And she went, well, you should have told me you wanted to be paid last night, earlier. I'm a drag queen. I have drugs to do. Of course I want my money that night. Yeah. You know, you don't think beauty like this comes naturally. Oh, no. Darvzan, Persak. Maybe a good old line, and then I begin to paint. And those of you in the front row going, she's got a lot of makeup on. I ain't painting for you. I'm painting those cheap bastards back there at the bar. I want them to look over and go, you know, she's kind of pretty from here. Just an old bitch trying to be hip. Ladies and gentlemen, if you will. Oh, I forgot to remind you. Oh, go ahead. I'm sorry. I'll do that later. Ladies and gentlemen, representing the Heavenly Horizon. Oh. Please forgive me if I get this name wrong. I always get it wrong. Ladies and gentlemen, if you will. Thank you. Ladies and gentlemen, contestant number 25, representing Heavenly Horizon, Regine Onyeg. 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 I apologize. Sorry. Regine Onyeg, and it is spelled K-A-L-A-N-I-P-R-O-D-U-C-T-I-O-N-S-O-N-S-O-N-S-O-N-I-G-N-E, one of them little weird little foreign hyphen things, R. Onye. Bitch! Yeah, that's right, and knife begins with an N. Ladies and gentlemen! That's why people who come to this country to learn English get back on the boat and go late. All right, ladies and gentlemen. Ladies and gentlemen, if you will, at the beginning of group six, please welcome to the stage, Mitt Central, Tri-States, Iowa. This will be contestant number 26, Ming Litton Dupree. 67, Ashton Taylor, representing North Carolina EOY. I gotta do something real quick. Hold on 1 second. Ladies and gentlemen, major kudos. This section right here, whoever the bitch has been who's come out has given them love and support. Please give these kids, I've got the right idea. Clap for all these contestants. They are from out of town, and it may not be the drag that you're used to, but it is the drag from their city. So please accept the representation. Y'all have been great. But, ladies and gentlemen, right here in the ball cap. Ooh, hi, how you doing? Oh, I forgot. Wasn't it your birthday last week? See, she's dumb, but not so dumb. Ladies and gentlemen, it was his birthday last Sunday. Give it up, and this is Eric, so on the count of three, say happy birthday, sexy motherfucker, on the count of three. Ready? One. All together now, black kids help the white kids out. We need prelim. Ready? All right. On the count of three. Sexy, happy birthday, sexy motherfucker. One, two, three.
Happy birthday, sexy motherfucker.
Very good. That was close to being good. Give him a round of applause. Happy birthday, Eric. Ladies and gentlemen, right here. In this corner, wearing the ball cap and the red shirt, the one, the only, ladies and gentlemen, former Entertainer of the Year, EOY, Miss Electra! And I love Electra for several reasons, but one of them mainly is because she smokes my bread. Ladies and gentlemen! I'm just kidding, I wouldn't do that, girl. No, bitch, because I know you. You'll poke me up in the eye. Oh, she said, I'm a former Entertainer of the Year. Oh, look. And they're in a box, too. Touch me in the morning. Ladies and gentlemen, also, I'm not going to introduce them right now because it's not worth my time. Ladies and gentlemen, these right here are your fabulous judges. Give it up for them. They're a hard judge. It's worth your time. Hurry up, go. Stall. Bitch, now I'm in go mood. I don't know what to do. I hurry you. Ladies and gentlemen, one of the judges I'm willing to do is look at you all bearded. Get ready for the weekend, aren't you, Butch? Ladies and gentlemen, Margo Davis right here. She's the owner of Burns Hair Salon. When you call, you will know it is Burns Hair Salon. It's an upper class. It is a salon, not a beauty parlor. It's a salon. You will know because when they answer the phone, they say, thank you for calling Bangs Hugh. And for a minute, you're taken back and you go, hi, is David there? If I want to go to the beauty parlor, bitch, you know what? I am sorry, but I am a homosexual who was born never with a hair gene. I was never born with a hair gene, don't have it, don't own it, don't even know where to get it. So, the hair that you see is the hair I can do. Fuck you. No, actually, I like my mop, girl, because I never know if I'm going to be rolling on the floor or what, so it's safer this way. Because I've seen these bitches come out with these beautiful hairsprays, like, girl, get down on the floor. No, my hair. Fuck you, Helen, it's a wig. Take it off, get on the floor, go. Right? Oh, my God. Tall and ten and young and lovely, the girl from prelim goes walking. Sorry. Right. The boy. You want to eat my pussy? Well, bitch, you're going to have to go to my house because the cat's at home. Bitch, I didn't know if I was going to make it out here today. I got home. I'm serious. I was late getting here. Because I got home and my cat was sitting there just kind of like, first off, I've had this cat since she fit in the palm of my hand. She is now, and God bless her, she's 18 years old. 18 fucking years old, still bouncing around the house, just having a good time. Is she a virgin? You know, actually she is. The bitch, she looked at me one night, she looked at me one day and went, meow! I said, oh, no, you don't. I was trying to get some sleep. She was all up in my face. So you can report me to the SPCA, but that was a happy cat that night. I got me a Q-tip and went to town. And the very next day, I said, here, fix this. And they went, and she got home and went, I'm hungry. So, but girl, she's 18 years old, and I got home and she was like, you know, really just kind of like not being herself. And I said, well, I hate to tell your name, Helen. I said, well, Helen, are you okay? I picked her up and said, you all right? She went, threw up all up and down me, and then threw up for the rest of the night, so I'm very worried about her, so my mind's on here. Ladies and gentlemen, if you will, give it up for representing.
Ladies and gentlemen,
representing Mid-Tri-State DOY. Contestant number 29, Alisa Summer.
Lost.
are.
And welcome to the stage, our 1993 National Entertainer of the Year, Shayla Simpson.
I never saw him again, In fact, I did not even know he had passed away until after the funeral had taken place. That's how he wanted it. So it would not sacrifice my chance of getting a green card to live here in America. On August 13th, 2000, I was crowned National Entertainer of the Year in Louisville, Kentucky. I have always wanted to entertain, whether it was in ballet, a female impersonation, to make people think, laugh, or cry. For the last 2 years, National Entertainer of the Year became a big dream of mine. And with a lot of hard work and belief, dreams can come true. So believe in all your hopes and dreams, whatever you do. Mom, I want to thank you and Dad for giving me such a wonderful start in my life and for letting me be who I am. Papa, this is for you.
Where are we again? The day I found you.
testicle.
Thank you.
Ladies and gentlemen, one more time. This wasn't your fault, really. This is supposed to be a handoff like a relay race, but you know, fags only know about running for the cops. Ladies and gentlemen, it's Kitty Litter. All right.
Kitty, this is your question. I'll ask it twice, and then you can give your response. In your bio, you stated that you have been in several national pageants. What has been your most valuable lesson learned in a national pageant? Once again, in your bio, you stated that you have been in several national pageants. What has been your most valuable lesson learned in a national pageant?
Good evening, ladies and gentlemen, most of all, my distinguished panel of judges. I am your contestant number 16, Ms. Kitty Litter. In answer to the question, that is true, I have been in several national pageants, and the most valuable lesson I have learned in a national pageant is, if you don't win, you keep going on. Like I stated in my bio, I dust myself off and I'm here to try again. I've been in this system for approximately 6 years now. Within the last 5 years prior to this year, I set many goals for myself, and all those goals wasn't met. But I stand here tonight to tell you, I do strive for excellence, because good things do come for those who wait. Thank you.
To run this microphone back and forth to the judges, and I have come up with a brilliant idea. What we're going to do is, could I have that microphone, please? Thank you. I'm going to leave this microphone down here, and I will hand this to the contestants. Call me stupid, but I think it'll work out better. This is for you, and the on-off switch is right there. Okay, thank you, love. Ladies and gentlemen, if you will. Bitch, I got more damn hair on. I feel like Charo. Yeah, well, that bitch from the Philippines doesn't get back and finish braiding this motherfucker. I'm gonna crack her right in her damn head. I said, I want the Bo Derek. And she said, poof, you're out of work. Ladies and gentlemen. Oh, I'm sorry. I didn't know there were so many Bo Derek fans in the audience. Gee, forgive me. Tim, hey. Ladies and gentlemen, we are about to start. By the way, you were fabulous on that question and answer. Just keep that up.